Hi, this is Glenn. I'm going to show you today, I've been getting a lot of requests for how to lower the watts on this demo kit. So I'm going to do a quick demonstration here and show you how you do this. Now, before we get started, I'm going to show you, you need four items. You obviously need your demo kit. You're going to need one of these little power strips. Get one with about 6 to 8 feet. 10 feet is going to be really good. You know, a little bit longer is going to be good for you. You'll see why in a minute. You're going to need a kilowatt meter. You can get these at Home Depot. They're about 25, 30 bucks. While you're at Home Depot, you also need to get a 100-foot extension cord. One of these orange ones works perfect. All right. So the first thing you're going to do is you're going to take your power strip, plug it into the wall, which we've already done. You're going to take your demo kit now. You're going to plug your demo kit into... There we go. Plug your demo kit into your extension cord. And then your extension cord is going to plug into your kilowatt meter. And then your kilowatt meter is going to plug in here to your power strip. So I'm going to turn everything on to amps. I'm going to show you why we do this and then explain how it works so you can go out and do this with your customers. Okay. So we switched everything over to amps. And you can see everything's pulling about the same. You do your typical demonstration. Excuse me. See if I can hold this up here so they look about the same height. Okay, so you know amps. Turn on the power saver. Motor's still getting the same 5.13 amps that it needs, but now you're only pulling 2.3 amps from the power company. The problem is, when's the last time you got an electric bill that shows that you were billed for so many amps? You don't. You're billed by watts, right? So what we need to do is turn this off, bring everything back to the same again. I'm going to flip everything over to watts. Let me take a look at the watts here. Now right off the bat, you're going to notice you have 144 watts coming from the motor, 144 watts from the board total, but once it goes down in through all this cord, this 100 foot of cord, you're now noticing that the power company is actually billing you for 170 watts when you really only need 144 watts. Now, this is why I've been telling you guys you need to have distance between the power company's electric meter and wherever the motor is at that you're going to install this. Just sticking this thing by the electric company's meter won't do anything. I'm going to flip this one over so you can't see it, and I'm going to show you. This is why you see this on the board. You look and you see no difference at all in the watts. If anything, they go up a little bit, right? You've been seeing videos on the internet. I'm sure you've seen one or two of those. But, oh, it's a scam. It doesn't work, et cetera, et cetera. You see they go down about 1 or 2 watts, maybe 3 watts. Okay, so this 170 watts. What you're doing is you're correcting the excess heat that builds up. Watts is power. So that takes a lot of power to push all this amperage through all this wire eventually over to your motor, right? So if this is the entryway of your house where your power company's electric meter is, it has to fight through all this wire eventually over to your motor, right? So what we're going to do when we flip this on, watch the watts that your power company's billing you for. Now they drop. This actually does reduce the watts. I think we got, what, about 11% drop there, something like that. You can do the math, probably come up with an accurate number. But that's basically how you do it. If you need to demonstrate to a customer, they say, yeah, you're showing me amps, but what about watts? You can take this extension cord and this kilowatt meter, and you can demonstrate, yes, it does save you watts. I hope that helps.